Hello and welcome to another part of my Recreating Napoleon's Empire campaign in EU4 Mew in Texas. So, I've been doing a little bit of looking over my country, and I got some problems here. If you've been following along, you might notice my corruption is 19. Which is a lot, because it's increasing all of my power costs by 20%. And that is due to the greater nobles. France has a ton of greater nobles at the start of the game, and they control 50% of my country right now. And there's that. And, I still have these appanages, these three appanages, and in order to get rid of that, I have to have overextension less than 1%. That is right here. Admin power of 150, overextension less than 1%. So I'm gonna stop taking provinces. For myself, at least, for a while. And my stability is not that great. But most of that was because of the greater nobles being mad at me the entire game. So I think I'm just gonna wait a bit. And, maybe go through some peacetime years. Maybe for a couple of years, at least. And I also spent all of my money in between the break on some buildings, so that's why I have no money. I didn't think it'd be that interesting to film that, so I didn't. I saved you. Saved you that. What is it? This is four. Who wants a thing? Who wants a royal marriage? I have four appanages? Yes, I have four appanages. Okay. Yeah, I need to annex these guys. I need to get them. What is this? Oh. Okay, that's not good. What are they? Millenarian heretics. They have... You lose some prestige, and they gain some autonomy. See, it's weird to me, because... These are my provinces that gain autonomy, but it's my... It's my vassals, it's my appanages, rebels, so I don't know why it affects me if it's my subjects' rebels. I don't really want to deal with those guys, but I guess I'll have to. What is this? Our Lady of Paris. A vision of the Virgin Mary. Paris gets center of Catholic pilgrimage for 13 years, or... Yeah, I'll take this one. Okay, Austria got re-elected. Interesting. I'm surprised I haven't eclipsed Spain or England. I don't know if that's because I'm falling behind. Oh, hey, it's not a negative. That's good. Okay, well, this is just okay. I'm sorry, but this is a little bit. I'm having. This is like, if you don't know, if you haven't watched the other parts, I had greater noble loyalty deteriorate 20, and then they became disloyal, and then it happened again, like 5 years later, maybe, and it went down to 11%. And during the break, I gave them a favor, or whatever the thing is. What is that? I gave them a privilege, and I got them back up to 31%. And then I just immediately get this greater noble loyalty deteriorates again. And this is where the problems stem from, the greater nobles. And it's just, it keeps hitting me with these things, and I'm teetering on the stability. If my stability goes negative, then I'm gonna have national unrest in the positive, and I'm gonna have a disaster. And it's these greater nobles that are doing this. And I'm not even sure if I've ever gotten a positive greater noble loyalty event that wasn't because their loyalty was already in the negative. It's just crazy how much I'm getting this. I don't even know if, I think it's just random. I can't even do anything to change it because it's not like I've, alright, well, at least I didn't lose stability, I guess. I have to deal with a rebellion in Provence. That's some positive money. That's good. Andrew gets eternal conflicts. How many rebels are coming? Ah, that's not bad. I should be able to beat them. There's a crusade in 1535. Oh, against Lauenburg? sure. What are these rebels? Separatists? I don't think I should have a problem. Although, I'm gonna get these guys over here in case I do. Just a precaution. That's good. Okay, handily defeated them. And now I can. Wait a couple months for the reinforcements to come back. Nope. Printing press. Formed. Alright, yeah, I don't care. 100 ducats, 5-year modifier, whatever. At least he's not greedy, so my taxation increased. I will do. Well, I don't want to lose stability, so I'm forced to do a massive celebration. I'm gonna get a royal marriage with Milan because I'm gonna have to move against them eventually, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna do that right now, so. Decentralize. Oh, come on. These estates are killing me. How's the Reformation coming? Okay, it's growing. It's gonna take a while. Alright, hey, my people influence recovered. That's nice. Alright. Well, I'd rather be Reformed than Protestant. I need to build some mines. Do I have a truce with Naples? Yes. 1537. So my intention is to get Naples as my vassal, and give them that territory back. That is my intention. Just looking at their ideas. Idea cost, mercenary maintenance, morale of armies, galley combat, goods produced, leaders without upkeep, income from vassals. They don't look that great. Do they really have 95? Jeez. That is, that's troublesome. That's very troublesome. Hopefully they never fight me. So, for the Netherlands, I need to get these two provinces. They have cores on those provinces. Poland have a claim here. They are part of the HRU? Really? Where's that thing? Yeah, they are. Okay. Two princes. That's a lot. Of course, there's a lot of free cities. I think I will start my assault on the Holy Roman Empire in earnest soon. I think I'm ready. Or at least more ready. Alright, I think first I'll take provinces down here. And then work my way up. Because right now, if I go in the middle here, I'm going to get a lot of aggressive expansion down here and up here. But if I start down here, it shouldn't hit up here as hard. So then I can work my way up. I have a truce with the Netherlands. And these guys aren't in the Empire, so I won't have to deal with Austria. I don't want to fight Milan, but I will have to eventually. Who are they allied with? Just France? Just me and Bologna? Alright. I think I'll give... Okay, well this is Ancona territory. Ancona. Padua and Papal State. I do not want to fight the Papal State. Dang it. I'm gonna fight Florence. Which means I'm going to end this part here. And thank you for watching. Please tune in for the French Florentine War of 1537. Thank you.